In the light of some of the recent events surrounding Bethesda, not only with releasing a game that wasn't up to the level that the fans hoped it would be, but also displaying and doing some practices which can be considered shady in regards to how they treat their audiences, it is no wonder that people are getting somewhat scared of what the releases of Starfield and eventually Elder Scrolls 6 will look like. Now, I'm not gonna say that Fallout 76 was an absolutely horrible game, even though by some standards it kind of was, because there are still people who genuinely enjoy it. I think we can, however, all agree that when it came out, it wasn't up to the level that it could have been and most likely should have been. For a lot of people, in fact, this has been a trend that has somewhat carried over from previous releases as well. The game simply not being up to the standard of the rest of the industry, and in some aspects, performing below what the audiences would expect. Now, in today's video, we will be somewhat looking at and analyzing the biggest fears that people have carrying over through to the eventual releases of Starfield and Elder Scrolls 6, and mainly discuss whether these can be fixed in time for those releases, or whether we should all just forget about Bethesda games. Now, before we start this, I just want to say that I am still a Bethesda fan. Some of their older titles belong into my favorite games of all time. I've played the heck out of Oblivion, and I have close to 8,000 hours played in Skyrim, but obviously, seeing the practices happening in the recent weeks, I too am starting to get somewhat worried for the future of the company. Of course, everything I'm going to be saying are simply my opinions, so feel free to disagree and let me know your opinions down in the comments below. But with that out of the way, get into your space shuttle, strap a sword to your back, and let's go. Now, the two biggest fears that I see being put out as arguments out there are usually A, the fear of the technology not being up to standard, aka the engine not being able to handle what they're doing, and the game itself being a buggy and poorly optimized mess. And the other fear simply being the company's ill practices, not caring about their audience or the product that they deliver, and simply slapping something together for a quick buck. Now, obviously, both Starfield and Elder Scrolls 6 are located somewhere in the unknown future. In fact, during E3, they were described as next generation games, with Elder Scrolls 6 for sure being planned somewhere further in the future. Now, if the engine is having trouble handling Fallout 76 right now, can it really pull something that's going to be going into the next generation of graphics and performance? Well, the thing is, yes and no at the same time. See, to understand this, let's first talk a little bit about engines. Now, a video game engine is the environment that provides a developer with the tools to create a video game. If you think about it, a video game to an engine is something like a finished edited painting to Photoshop. Different games benefit from having different engines, as just as any other program. Different engines have different strengths and provide the developer with different tools. Now, the thing is, Bethesda has obviously been repurposing their engine for every new release for a long time, ever since the days of Morrowind, actually. So what is happening now? Can they simply keep this going on forever? Well, partially. The problem that seems to be happening right now is that they're running into the issue of the core infrastructure and setup of the engine not being able to fully support all of the additions on top of it. What this means is that if they truly want the maximum power from it, chances are it's not going to be enough to simply scrape and slightly adjust some of the top layers. They will require more of a deep down into the core of the engine and fixing some of the larger issues so that then the top layers can be built on top and move on to the next generation. Now, would this be easier and cheaper for them than creating a completely new engine? It's honestly hard to say, but chances are, considering the developers are most likely familiar with how the engine works, it will be easier for the engine programming team to update and fix an already existing framework rather than building something completely new from the scratch. Of course, their options with going into the next generation are also acquiring a completely new engine. However, this obviously creates a lot of risks for them, as in the entire studio having to adapt to a new framework, new technology, and a new way of designing games and quests. The thing that they really need to do in order to fix the problem is take some additional time, do a deep dive on the engine, and make sure the core of it is stable and strong enough in order to pull the rest. Obviously, with this hand in hand, doing this will require a ton of effort, and people are worried, as I already mentioned, that they simply do not care enough, and that they will not have the incentive to adjust their technology and create other worthwhile products in the future. Obviously, no one can say whether they will or they won't. However, the important thing here to remember is that the community can make or break a game developer company. The fact of the matter is that how your audience views your work is often far more important than how good the work actually is. If you're a good and grounded developer that your audience supports, they like your new releases and they play the heck out of them and they understand the value you put into them, even if you have one or two games that don't go so well, they're still willing to trust you if you go back, rework the system and create another good product. For Bethesda, Fallout 76, regardless of how they're handling it, is undoubtedly going to be a big hit, maybe not necessarily on the amount of money they've earned because they've sold a ton of copies, but on how the general audiences view the company and their future works. Obviously, multiple games from them in the future will be looked at with a grain of salt and will be first judged from a distance following the somewhat disastrous release of 76. To an extent, for them, it's not just about the audience liking or not liking them. It can eventually lead to the company ceasing to exist if they don't play their cards right. So I guess while the audiences are right to worry about how those releases will look, chances are Bethesda might be even more worried, considering if this trend goes on, they might soon find themselves in a situation where the new games are not making as much money as they would need to keep them afloat. So, to wrap this video up, is the worrying from the side of the audience justified and in the right place? Yes, it definitely is. If Bethesda doesn't fix some of their technology and change the attitude that they seemingly had going into Fallout 76, then we might be looking at truly disastrous releases for Starfield and eventually Elder Scrolls 6. Now I know that a lot of the audience is angry and still feeling sour, but a part of me still believes that seeing how this disaster played out, Bethesda will go back, analyze what cards they have been dealt, and play them to the best of their abilities. At least the one good thing coming out of this is that both Starfield and Elder Scrolls 6 seem to be quite the ways off, giving them ample opportunities to make sure that they run good, that they're fun to play, and that the content is worthwhile for the entire audience that they're still trying to entertain after all these years. Anyways, that is it from me in this more discussion-oriented video. Hope you guys found it interesting. If you have a different opinion or you would like to add on this, maybe explain what your thoughts are on the upcoming releases of Starfield and Elder Scrolls 6, make sure to let me know down in the comments below. Maybe we can start an interesting discussion. I want to wish you guys a bit of rest off this rainy Saturday, and I'm going to see you in whatever next video I make. Bye-bye.